What's up, everybody? It's Boy Meme here. I started recording my video. What's happening? Okay. I started recording my video, studying for like 20 minutes, but then I accidentally doxed myself, so I had to stop recording. This is the new recording. I decided to play some Factorio. I just got this new smelting thing set up, which I'm pretty happy about. I was having this really weird issue where coal was getting mixed in with the iron, but I got that fixed. Because the coal and iron deposits are right next to each other, and so I just have these filters here where whenever iron gets into the coal, it goes into these chests, and then it goes into the iron supply, and then whenever coal gets into this iron belt, it gets filtered out and it goes into the coal supply. And I originally had this figured out, but I didn't have this figured out. I didn't know that my iron supply was mining any coal, so I was having some weird issues with that, but now it's fixed. And now I have 3 out of 4 iron smelters set up for my main bus, which you can see here. How's it pollution? That's not that bad. Not as bad as my landfill setup, which I've mostly got this lake done, so this is just running. I have so much landfill. This is all landfill in here, like full chest of landfill. It's crazy. Yeah, same over here, I believe. And same over here, even though there's barely any landfill left. There's barely any stone left, I mean. Looking at this, is just so inefficient compared to like my almost peak efficiency mining setup. There is a better mining setup, but it involves underground belts, and I don't want to use that. See, look, there's a couple of pieces of coal. They're gonna get filtered out. See? Go down here and go into the coal supply, and they get used, which I'm happy about. A big issue with my original factory is that I had an individual coal supply. As you can see, I ended up splitting off the coal into many things, but I had an individual coal supply for, oh, this is actually split into 3 things. It's terrible. But yeah, I had an individual coal supply for every single smelting area, and that was really stupid because you could have like one coal supply many smelting areas because a factory only needs a little bit of coal. Except for running the steam engines, of course. Yeah, look at this, running at peak efficiency. An entire full iron belt just from these smelters. And I have 3, you can't really see them, but these are this and this and this are 3 full iron belts. Look, it's just mining because there's an entire belt of iron. It's actually not an entire belt of iron because of that coal thing. But what can you do? It's almost an entire belt. And the coal will be out pretty soon, so I won't have to worry about that. It's just mined here. Follow this piece of iron. It'll be messed up when you get near the splitters, but what can you do? And then it goes into here. Or gets sorted out to see if it's coal or not. Which it isn't. It goes through here. You can tell it's not running at max efficiency because sometimes these last two furnaces aren't running. But with these, they're at peak efficiency because they have a full iron supply, but this doesn't necessarily. But even then, the buffer should fix that. I should put lights in here. It makes sense that stone is still the highest. Stone production has steadily been going down because the stone supply has been going down. I'm gonna lock in now. Oh, whoops. Yeah, because why would it be the BIOS? That makes sense. BIOS issues don't really have anything to do with external displays. That would be weird. Okay, this is such a strange question. That one's obvious because it has the answer in its name. I mean, a touchscreen could use a stylus. I think a digitizer could use a stylus. I'm gonna say touchscreen. Okay, digitizer, sure. I think the answer might be 4. Yeah. Because it always talks about known good spares a lot. They just always love talking about known good spares, and a lot of the time, when you have an answer that has a known good spare, that's usually the one. And all the other ones didn't really make too much sense, so. Okay. That's so stupid. Windows laptops do that now. I think, this is crazy, but my ThinkPad does that now. Whenever you press an FN key, it switches, it's a modifier to switch to the F keys, which is crazy to me. In the past, the F keys are the ones that are prioritized, and then you switch, The F keys are the ones that are prioritized, and then you switch to the multimedia keys. That's the way it is on my keyboard, at least, and that's the way it is on any Windows laptop I've ever used. But I don't know, it's very strange. Now that I think about it, I think I should use the F keys some more, but I don't know, they're used for like so many random different things in applications, like F11 full screens, but I could just do Control F and it does the exact same thing, or Windows F, like Meta F, you know? I think MSI is for installers, and I don't know if they would call that a Windows system file, so I'm gonna go for VXD and DLL, even though I don't know what VXD is. Sure. Because they have boot camp. Oh god, Vim questions. It's funny because I use Vim every day, right? You can see it in my autocomplete, right? But it's just the way these are worded is very just strange. My brain has an urge to just be like, oh, just say an answer so then you can get the right answer so you can go past this one. But I know that's bad, right? Oh god, I actually don't know this one. It's not 4. It's not 3. Because you don't press insert and then you press insert. Because I would just go into insert and then you type I. You know? It's like, what? So it's not 3 or 4. It's gotta be 1. What? Press insert and then press insert again? What? No, you just go into insert and you press I. Am I missing something? Press the S key and then press insert. What? Maybe this is for VI. No, but that just... I think this is just wrong. I think they're just wrong on this one, but okay. Very, very strange. Okay. How's my thing doing? Since no coal is being used, I'll have to assume that the iron is... Oh, coal is being used. I'm going to have to assume that maybe the last chest or last couple chests are being filled. Yeah, last chest. Cool. Okay. And so it's just a little bit of iron. Nice. On Linux, it's typically always the R switch for recursive. Oh, actually, I don't know if that's what that was asking. My bad. It tries to trick you by saying image of data and one of the answers being PNG because that's an image file. Tricky. Isn't it WPA2 and TKIP? Oh, AES, okay. Slippers. One sec, I have to get laundry. I'll just be a couple minutes. The answer, I think, is going to be this, but the answer is also this. I'm certified in fiber optics, and I know that they have a lower installation cost. A lot of the time, broadly. Also kind of has the answer in its question. I don't know what a trace provider is. Oh, so is it just like a part of an application that just logs things, but they call the logs traces? Yes. I learned something new, and the information was easy to find. So that makes sense in that context, because you're enabling, seeing. This is way too dark, but when I did my camera settings, it made a lot of sense. Like, it was way brighter when I made these camera settings, and now they're super dark and it looks really weird, but I can't change them without my camera freezing, so. I can't lie, those battery ones, I just guess. But I think I get them right, like, like two-thirds of the time. So I think subconsciously I might know, but I don't know. It's rough. Whenever it mentions class one or class two, they're always talking about Bluetooth. Sure, okay. Because if she has three discs, the thing with the best, like, parity would be three discs with the data mirrored across all three of them. This one, you can tell that this one's correct because it's the longest. When I started out making these questions and there was more than one answer, I would have just all three answers in one question, and that would result in the right answer being really long. But something I learned is whenever you have something like this, you just need to have all three, and you just need to randomize the order and which ones are in there. So it's one, but you know, it's an artifact. Is it because it's always trying to connect to new, like, networks, like cellular stuff? I think I can close my game now. I think it's done here. I think this playtime is for me playing it in the background. What did I even do here? Okay. Whoa. Okay. Making low density structures, substations. Wow. I forgot about substations. Wow. Oh, this just freaks me out. Oh, this menu doesn't make sense. Yikes. I had a tank? Whoops. Weird. Oh well. That's crazy. Okay. Back to locking in. Sorry, guys. Oh, of course. I didn't know that's what it was saying about DNS. I should have paid more attention. This is a really bad, It could also be like a boot disk that's not plugged in, right? For inaccessible operating system, or would that be like boot disk not found or something, not operating system not found? I don't know, AMR? PCI, okay, sure. On Windows, 64? Okay, 20, sure. That's such a weird updating a 64-bit machine. That's such a vague term. Right. I'm going to say mini PCI because I've never heard of it before. Okay. Oh, I know mini PCI. Whoops. That's embarrassing. You also do need to activate. Configuring the user environment, I guess it's different. Maybe it's referring to like some sort of unattended installation or something that hasn't activated by default. There are like four questions in here about evil twin attacks. It's so strange, and they're all different. That's just not true. Yeah. Oh, those are the same answer. My neck is craned like this, and I'm trying to keep it up, and it's very difficult. Thank you. Be right back for just 1 second. I never really use Molex connectors. Oh, I meant to choose DDR4, but I pressed 4 instead, so that went DDR3. But either way, I would have been wrong because I should have chose DDR. I should have chose memory that is supported by the motherboard. I didn't even read that. I was like, oh, that's his GDDR4, but he didn't even read number two. Okay. I'm pretty sure I don't even have IF config on here. Yeah, I have IP. Oh, that's really weird. My keyboard doesn't work. What? That's so weird. My mouse totally works, but my keyboard just isn't working. What? Wait. Okay, I guess my keyboard just isn't working in Alacrity? Okay. That was really weird. I was thinking I had to stop recording, but that was really strange. I should have known that was ifconfig though. It's over. Okay. T? Okay. Oh, sure. I was thinking like swipe. Honestly, I didn't even read swipe lock. I didn't even read that. Oh, it's over. That's true, because they have like Rel and stuff, and Sousa. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Because I'm thinking, like, oh, host file, right? But I said LM host, and so I wasn't sure. It might be this. Yeah. Okay, sure. That makes sense. Because Cat6A is, I'm pretty sure the only difference is that it's shielded twisted pair as opposed to unshielded twisted pair. That's why the A stands for augmented and not E for enhanced, like Cat5E. That makes sense. I meant to do clean installation. Sorry. Sorry. I'm gonna check Amazon really quick. I'm gonna see how much M-discs cost, but I'm gonna pause this time so I don't dox myself. Wow, M-discs are really expensive. It's crazy. Oh, prevents you from using a GUID for a decision table. No, I meant the other way around. My bad.
Okay.
Oh, whoops, I just saw the slash I and I chose it, but I didn't know it said a remote. Oh, okay. Sure. Right, okay. Sure, okay. Oh, a microwave signal. Weird. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay. I did something wrong. That's weird. Sure, okay. That makes sense. Because of overheating. Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, is it like DRM? I see. I need to do laundry really quick. Hello, all. I ended up chatting with my dad and I have chocolate in my mouth. Also, my mom's home, so I'm gonna mute my microphone. I didn't read the question. hey, we win these. We win these. Okay. I'm gonna do a few more terms. There are ones that I'm like iffy on that it says. There are ones that it says I'm iffy on, which I think is a pretty large majority of them. And then I'm just gonna go through a few of those, and then I'm gonna do a practice test and see how I do. The passing grade for, yeah, still learning, 783. Which is weird. I wonder if still learning is just ones that I didn't get right first try. This is very strange. Okay, I guess I'll update the computer in the background. No, actually, I can put it over here. That's so weird. I guess I'll just try like restarting the page. Or you know what? For even better measure, I'll just restart my browser. Do I still have Zed installed? Okay, good. Okay, should I just try and open this in Chromium? Exact same issue. That's so strange. Okay, well, I'm gonna keep that running. I'm gonna do laundry really quick, and then I'm gonna, if that hasn't fixed it, I'll just do like a quiz on Quizlet or something, and then I'll do a practice test, like an actual practice test. Okay, so I'm back and it's having the same issue, so I'm just gonna do a practice test. I'm gonna bring that up on my second monitor. That's my new wallpaper, by the way. That's why my borders around my windows are orange. Okay. I actually think it's that. Oh, one sec. Sorry, everyone. Do you guys hear that? There's a very weird bird outside. Weird. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Oh, I think it might be. I want to say personalization because that's like a weird, like, Windowsy place to put it when it really should be an ease of access, but I think it's in devices. Because from devices, I think you can go into mouse settings, and then there's an option, I think. About two-thirds of the way done with this test, and then I'm going to do the practice test, but I'll pause it while I'm doing that because that stuff you have to pay to see, but all the questions are the same. It's the same questions. Ah, it's one of these. I'm gonna go for except leaves, but it could be either one. No, because they're not talking about the use of things. I'm gonna go for user education and awareness. microphone. My parents are home, so I'm going to mute my microphone. Okay, that's not great. The passing score, it's okay. The passing score for the practice test on CertMaster, which is what these questions are based off of, is 95%. And that's quite high, but the thing is that the CompTIA A+ exam itself has a passing score of around 87%, or to like 88 or 89% or so. And so, if I were to take the test, like the CompTIA A+ exam, I would be passing it about, it is two tests, right? So I'd have to pass both, but I'd be passing it about. But the really spooky thing is that, if you aren't getting 95% correct, then it's less and less likely that you're gonna get, 89% correct. So that's why the passing score on the CompTIA A+ exam is 95. Right now, I'm gonna pause the video, and when it's unpaused, you're gonna see my score on the CompTIA, like, A+ official practice exam, for the first one, and I guess the second one. And I'm not expecting to get a 95% passing score, and frankly, basing off of my 90% score here, I'm not even expecting to get even, maybe I'll get an 85, I'm thinking, which sucks, right? But it just means I need to study more, and we'll see. I'm just tempering my expectations. I could even get into the 70s. But we'll see. When I unpause, you'll see my score for the first test in the CompTIA A+ practice exam. Okay, so for Core 1, there's a passing score of 75%, and I got a score of 82%, which isn't great, but You know, it's fine. It's fine. There are some questions, though, which is really, which are, like, not answerable in a multiple choice question format. So, like, these where you have to select, like, the PCIe slots. Just stuff like this I might mess up on, which is weird. What? Oh. I guess that is wrong. Yeah, because it has three slots, huh? Okay. Sure, okay. That makes sense. But, yeah, so passing score for the actual exam, 75%. I got an 82 on this, which, you know, is fine. I'm going to do the Core 2 exam now, which has a passing score of... ...77%, so I'll do that. Okay, so I got an 83, and the passing score is 77 for Core 2, so I'm definitely over. It's really dark now, because it's really dark outside. It's relatively dark outside. I set these camera settings when it was sunny, and now it's not sunny anymore, it's cloudy and kind of dim, so it looks really dark. But this means that if I did the CompTIA A+ exam, I'd have a pretty good chance at doing it correctly, but if I'm unlucky and I have a pretty high amount of questions that I'm not too sure about, there's a pretty good chance that I would fail, right? So I'm going to study a little more. Until I get my scores a little higher, probably in the high 80s to the low 90s, hopefully 95, which is the passing score for the practice test. And then I'll be good. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope everybody has a wonderful day. And for dinner, we're having shulap, which I'm happy about. And yeah, see you, dude. Oh, I also got invited to Deadlock, which is cool. Valve's game that is not announced yet, but that everyone has. It's very cool. Yeah, goodbye.